86 members here. She was their evidence. Where in the Holy Quran say that the Bible is that the Bible is correct and is truth? Show to us. By the way, still we know that you don't know how to read the Quran from Abu Musa. And Abu Musa similar time offered to Christian brothers to kill, to teach you, to give you some lessons how to read the Quran. You were lying to the Christians. You were telling them that you are a scholar in Islam. You were telling them that you are ex-imam. You were telling them that you are memorizing the Holy Quran. And we find out that you are not able to read one verse from the Holy Quran, Christian brothers. And you come to tell us now that the Quran saying that the Bible is correct. So let's be fair here, Christian brothers. You have already got the link. Provide me your evidence where in the Holy Quran saying that the Bible is correct. You might.
Well, you might, but you don't need to let me talk. Mister, your prophet in Sunan Ibn Dawood, he swore by the Torah and he took an oath in his time. So if, let me please post. Don't flood the room, please. If you want to show evidence, don't flood the room. If you're a prophet, he took an oath swearing by the Torah, and the Torah is corrupted. It's mean your prophet must be a person who lie. Because why you want to
swear? Who lie? Who's the idea, Christian? Where? You are posting the link, Christian, you're coming for me with links? With links you come for me? You coming with your links with me? Boost me, show me. Boost for everyone. Here, boost. Put anything from everyone. Malaysia, Khan, please, leave me with the... He came to fry me. Leave him to fry me. I want to see how Christian Prince wanted to fry me. Don't stop voting. Should I leave the room and I read your hacking links? Huh? And what hadith is this? Put the hadith. Why you don't put the hadith in the text, Christian Prince? Tell me, huh? Why didn't you put the hadith? Put the hadith in front of everyone. Let us read it. I will read it gladly. Christian brothers, I would come to the mic and read it. Ah, look, subhanAllah, he's always boasting hadith for the Christians who do not read Arabic, he's boasting in Arabic. Okay. Let's see here what is Christian brothers saying. فاحكم بينهم فوضعوا لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسادة فجلس عليها ثم قال بالتوراة فأمي بها فأتي بها فنزع الوسادة من تحتي فوضع التوراة عليها ثم قاملت ثم قال آمنت بك وبما أنزلك. So is that hadith? Give me the narration of the hadith, Christian Brains. How many times I have to teach you when we're going to speak about hadith, Christian Brains? And you move the topic from Quran to Bible, you jump to Hadith now, because it's much more area for you to spread your lie there, much more space for you to spread your lie. And you said that the Quran said that the Bible is truth, and now you jump to the Hadith. So you are confused here. It is the Quran or it is the Hadith, Christian Prince? Now, put me the narration of this Hadith. Put me. Is this hadith authenticated or not authenticated? You know very well if you are calling yourself a scholar in Islam, if you are claiming that you are a scholar in Islam, you should first of all check or speak this hadith, it is sahih or not sahih. These all the Muslims, this is the Muslim how they think, this is the Muslim how they deal with the hadith. You have to understand this. You have to understand this, Christian Prince. Several times when I came to your room for 2 minutes, I teach you how we read the hadith even. How we read. You can't just tell anything from the hadith. Who said this hadith? Narrated by who? You are telling me you are boasting the new text. Who is telling you the hadith? So it's enough, Christian. Christian Prince, you are just exposing the same from the Christian. All of you here, they know what lying you have. We know in the deep heart that you are lying in Islam. His orchestra, yeah, brother and sister, all guests here, Keshe Embrace, he came up to the mic. He said that that the Quran telling us that the Bible is truth. When we tell him truth for us, he put us hadith. I told him, show me where the Quran tell us that the Bible is truth. When we ask him this, Keshe Embrace, he put us hadith. I just wonder, are you just dancing around? Christian says, you said the Quran, you said the Hadith, and you bought the Hadith. I don't know from where you bring it. Come on, your mic, let us see what you want to get to us. And you do not need to say that our Prophet is lying or is not lying, because our Prophet, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is the Prophet and Messenger of Allah, and he never lied. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُ الْرُوحَىٰ. From the Holy Quran is saying. So you do not need to lie. So now, if the Hadith was correct, because as a Muslim, I told you before, previously, question is, when I read the Hadith, I have to check and I have to know if they are narrated by who. The sheet of the narration, so I can tell you if it is authenticated or not. So, when you first, I have to teach you how to voice the hadith first. When you voice the hadith, Christian boys, please voice the narration, so I can immediately ask to you if this hadith is correct or not. Now, I need you to put me the narration or the narrated of the hadith from who. Who was the hadith narrated by who? Your mic. I want to know the hadith narrated by who. Your mic, your question, please.
Thank you, Muslim. I hope you will let me talk, because what people will notice that you hold the mic for 15 minutes, I hold the mic for 5 seconds. And all those 15 minutes just to answer the 5 seconds I had the mic? This is weird. Number one, this is in Sunan Ibn Dawood, the book of Al-Hudud, Fi Rijm al-Yahud. حديث نمبر 3859 حدثنا أحمد بن سعيد الهمداني حدثنا ابن وهب حدثني هشام بن سعد أن زين بن أسلم حدثه عن ابن عمر قال. This is the narration, and this is coming in حديث مالك بن نافع too, and this is about the story of stoning to death. Now you're a prophet, he is taking an oath according to your Islamic books, Islamic scholars, not according to me. So you don't blame me for what the Muslims say about their prophet. Don't accuse them to be Hindus. Secondly, if you're a prophet, is practicing the regime, which means stoning to death, and this does not exist in your Quran, can you tell me from where your prophet he got the stoning to death?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم. Have mic check إن شاء الله. Mic check. Why aren't you answer the question, CP? Why you changing the subject? You think we're gonna let you're acting like an idiot. Why aren't you answering the question? The brother is asking you a question. No, you didn't. You didn't answer any question. You went somewhere else. Okay, brother, but you see, he's not answering, Yaki. He's not answering. So let me give you the mic back, Yaki Muslim Knight. Take the mic, Yaki. But you see, just don't let him go somewhere else, Yaki. Let him answer the question. Go ahead, take the mic, Yaki.
Okay, I'm answering. Why you stop me? He asked me how you prove that this is what the Prophet did. And can you show me the narration I was reading for him? And the hadith itself, I'm not changing the topic. The topic is about the corruption of the Bible. Your prophet, he don't have in his book anything about stoning to death. He took it from the book of the Jew. Now can you show me where we can find the stoning to death? Simply he was reading from the Torah, and he was practicing what is in the Torah. Because in your Quran, there is no stoning to death. Correct? Or I'm lying. Now show me one verse in the Quran about stoning to death. If it is not there,
I can answer you for this hadith, but after I answer you for this hadith, Christian Prince, after I answer you for this hadith, I want you to respond to me and to show me where in the Holy Quran saying the Bible is correct. Because this is your statement, Christian Prince. I will answer you through the hadith. Can I? Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now, question is, regarding this hadith, when the Jewish came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they have an issue between them and each other, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, do you accept to judge you? Do you accept to judge you from your own book? Do you accept to judge you from your own book? Brothers and sisters, this is a proof how fair and great the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Muhammad, peace be upon him, he did tell them, I should judge you in according to Holy Quran. I should judge you in according to the Islam faith. But Christian prince is still thinking that he